Hello everyone, welcome to Mofa Crochet. This is Fatma from Mofa Crochet. Today our tutorial will be about how to do a chain. So the chain is a basic technique actually in crochet, and it's so much important for crochet for the beginners to learn, because if you learn how to do the chain, you will know how to do the other type of stitches. So to begin with, what you will need is yarn, any type of yarn, but I prefer a thick weight yarn so you can practice on it, and a crochet hook. I'm using a 4mm crochet hook. So let's get started. Alright, let's begin. So to begin with, I did a slip knot and I attached my crochet hook. By the way, there is a link in the description, and I will attach the video later at the end on how to do the easiest way of how to tie a slip knot, the really easy way for beginners. So to begin with, I want to teach you how to hold the yarn. Most of the tutorials I saw, they are starting directly on doing the chain. I know some of the beginners don't know how to hold the yarn, and they will struggle and it will be tangled. So the best way to hold the yarn is by taking the two fingers here, and you will pass the yarn like this. You're gonna have a grip on the yarn with these two fingers, and wrap the yarn on this finger and hold the slip knot. So again, how to hold the yarn: take the yarn, pass it over your hand, hold the yarn with these two fingers, wrap the yarn around this finger, and hold the knot, the slip knot, with these two fingers. Now you know how to hold the yarn, let's get started. Okay, you're gonna take the crochet hook and yarn over and take the yarn slowly and pull to the loop. To make it for you easier, I'm gonna zoom in. Yarn over and pull up a loop. Again, I'm gonna do it again. Yarn over and pull up a loop. Here we have three chain stitches. I'm gonna do again. Yarn over and pull up a loop. The chain size, it depends on how strong you are tying the yarn, and what is the size of the loop of the slip knot. So if I did it so much tight, it will be small chain. If I release the little bit of the slip knot loop and I yarn over and pull up a loop, it will be a big chain. So it depends on your tension. And you see, now I'm gonna do it in the faster way so you can see how it's going on. I'm holding the yarn like how I told you, and I'm gonna yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull up a loop, and like this. Now I have ended up with a chain. This is called a chain. It looks like a real chain actually. And during any crochet patterns, they will ask you to do a chain one, chain two, chain three. So it's as simple as this. It's just like yarning over and pulling a loop, yarning over, pulling a loop, yarning over, pulling a loop, and count how many chains needed. Try to do it more at home, and let me know in the comments if you got it right. And yeah, that's it for today's video. Hope you liked it and enjoyed it. stay tuned for more videos. Please don't forget to hit like and subscribe to support my channel. Bye!